BT's Green Thumb, brought to you by St. Mary's Nursery, every Wednesday morning on Breakfast Television.
Welcome back. Carla Hersina joining us once more. Thanks for being here, Carla. A little earlier on, you gave us some tips of what we can do to the soil to get it ready for the next growing season. But we're not totally done with this growing season. The topic of discussion here is adding some extra color so we can get a nice fall seasonal look, correct?
Exactly. Like, now we're starting to see the beautiful rich tones of the, you know, the deeper, richer color palettes that are in the garden. And when you're looking at it, it's time to switch up and take a look at it. It's kind of interesting because when you've designed your garden and you look at it, you take a step back and you see the rich color tones of, you know, spring, summer. But now you want to sort of see, and this is sort of a perfect time that you can go and look at areas of the garden that are kind of void of color.
Okay.
And that's when you go, you know what, this is where I need that pop of color. That's the extension. Because the color palettes and the plants that I brought you, they're beautiful colors, but the other thing that's really cool about them is it was really crisp and cool this morning.
Uh-huh.
These guys love those cool temperatures. So this is gonna, these colors are gonna take your garden from summer into those late autumn, you know, color
and
temperatures.
As that transition happens, so we're looking at these flowers right now, but if we just go over to the side, we can see that even when these guys start to lose their petals, we're still left with a really beautiful sort of shape and color and texture here, which I guess was good planning and something deliberate that we'd want to think about, right?
Yep, you've got it. This is Gaillardia, and the Gaillardia is also called blanket flower, so you have the colors that are in through here, and these are actually the development where you can see the petals are starting to lose or drop, mm-hmm. and then this is the formation of the seed heads for next year.
Gotcha.
So again, we called it the cycle of the garden.
Uh-huh.
So we're going through it. And even on sort of the ornamental grasses and the rutabagas, the black-eyed Susans, we see ornamental grasses with the blades and the color tones that are in them. We have annuals, we have perennials, but then you get these beautiful bottle brush textures in some of the grasses that are on it. And Peroscava. If you want something, this is here. We were talking, we were matching mm-hmm. your shirt.
Yes.
This is Peroscava.
The Peroscava.
Russian sage. Hard to say. But there's aromatics too. So just give it a little bit of a brush with your hands and you'll smell that it has a little bit of a pungent little scent that's to it. So a little bit more in tune to what, you know, a color tones, if you like, more of the pinks that are going into it. Sedums, the rich ones, I know I'm bouncing around here. The sedums here. This one here, my daughter used to call it, which are little broccoli heads.
Uh-huh.
But it actually, you can start to see some of the pink color tones that are in that. So those are going to open up with the florets and turn to this pinky salmon color tones. And again, we're looking at this and we encourage the colorants of fall gardens because the next step is these plants are going to stay tall and strong so that when we get into the next season, which is going to be winter, they're going to have beautiful frost. They'll hold the frost.
Yeah.
They'll have that. So the winter garden becomes now something that's very unique and beautiful in that side too. So we have to think of each stage of gardening.
Well, yeah, because we're doubling down to get a couple of extra seasons in here because we're still on the tail end of summer, but we want something that's going to look great for fall. And like you mentioned, we could even still have something beautiful when the frost comes. I don't want to use the F word again.
Not yet, but, not yet.
It's good planning to be able to make sure that we have the right stuff.
This one I wanted to because the girls were good in the greenhouse. They gave me a really cute selection. These are ornamental peppers. So if this I probably wouldn't put into the garden.
Mm-hmm.
This is, and these guys here, if you have that pop of color and you have those beautiful big containers by the front door and some plants are not looking good, take your trowel, pop those out, and pop in a little bit of fall color. We even have scarecrows that you can put inside. I forgot to bring them. They're unpacking
them.
Scarecrows, picks, and, you know, ornamental cabbages and pretty soon pumpkins.
Oh,
pumpkins. Pop some pumpkins into those containers. Take your containers, take your garden to fall.
So many great ideas to get those rich fall colors in our gardens. Carla, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
If you want to peruse yourself, best thing to do is connect with Carla and take a visit to St. Mary's Nursery. You can get all that information on the BT website at breakfasttelevision.ca. We'll take a little break. More coming up later this morning on City.
I remember you painted some flowers in your room.